Hello students, I am your Lata ma'am. In this academic year, I will take social science subject to you. For this academic year, in the 9th standard social science, you have two textbooks, part 1 and part 2 textbooks. In part 1st social science textbook, the lessons are under the 6 subtopics. Those are history, economics, political science, sociology, geography and business studies. In history related units are 4, economics based units are 2 and business studies based units are 1, geography based units are 5 and sociology based units are 3. So totally 17 units in this academic you have. So today I am going to teach you the first lesson in history. The name of the lesson is Christianity and Islam. Before going to start the lesson, we should know the date in history. Why we write the dates or periods in history, we should write in two types. That is BCE and AD. What is the full form of BCE and AD? BCE full form is before Christ era. BCE, before Christ era. And AD full form is Anno Domini. In Kannada, Krista Shaka and Krista Purva. So here, look at the blackboard. Why you start to write scale in mathematics, you should need scale. When you write the scale, it will start from 0. The right side of the 0, it starts with plus. Plus 1, plus 2, plus 3, plus 4, like this. And before the 0, we should write with the minus. Minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, like this. Same as in history, we write the dates from 0 to onwards with in order wise 1, 2, 3, 4 up to 2020, present year. But before 0 to before, we start the dates of history in reversed order 1, 2, 3, 4, like this. It is considered as BCE and 0 to right side is considered as AD, Anno Domini and before Christ era. This is the difference between BCE and AD. So in this chapter, I am going to teach you Christianity and Islam. These were established in 1st century CE. What is the meaning of CE? I already explained it. CE means Christ era, means before Christ era. In this period, the Christianity and Islam religions established. These two religions are known as Semitic religions. What is Semitic? Semitic means the people who lived in Middle Asia are known as Semitic races. It means Christianity and Islam religions originated in Central Asia, then it came into prominence in other countries after. That's why we considered these two religions are Semitic religions. Let us discuss one by one. First we move on to Christianity. The religion Christianity is established in the beginning of 1st century CE in Nazareth province of Palestine. Palestine is near Israel. Palestine na Nazareth anuvanta pranthadalli Christianity belakige bantu. When? In the beginning of 1st century CE. Before the arrival of Christianity, the Jews of Palestine had become superstitious practices. What it means? Superstitious practices in Kannada, Moodanambikegalu. Jews antandre Yahudigalu. So Jews of Palestine had become superstitious practices. In this time, Jesus Christ was born and founded Christianity. So let us know the early life of Jesus Christ. Students, we don't have much information about Jesus Christ's early life. We don't have much sources, but available sources are suggested Jesus Christ was born in a poor family of Joseph and Mary. So Joseph and Mary were the parents of Jesus Christ. The father of Jesus Christ was Joseph and mother is Mary. So Jesus Christ was born at Bethlehem near Jerusalem. Jerusalem is near Israel. Jerusalem na hattira iruva Bethlehem nalli Jesus Christ huttidaru. He was born at Bethlehem near Jerusalem. At the age of 30, Jesus Christ was influenced by John Baptist and after baptized by John Baptist and after that John called Jesus Christ as Messiah or Savior. Baptized andre deekshayanna padkondru John Baptist inna. After that John called him as a Messiah or Savior. Maharakshaka anthe John Jesus Christ anna karadru. So here Jesus Christ was strongly influenced by John Baptist. After this he started teaching to the people of Palestine. It means he enlightened the people distressed by his teachings and made them psychologically strong. Day by day in Christianity Jesus Christ became strong for his kindness and services to the poor people. Gradually people considered Jesus Christ was a godly man. Devata manushya anta karidakke shuru madidru. But one class in Jews were opposed this progress of Jesus Christ, that is priestly classes. In Kannada sampradayavadigalu anta karithivi. Priestly classes of Jews were opposed this progress and complained to the governor of the Roman Empire. The name of governor is Pontius Pilate. Pontius Pilate charging Jesus Christ was a treason. After this inquiry, Jesus Christ was taken to Golgotha on Friday and crucified Jesus Christ on the cross. Students, have you know what is cross? I will write the picture of cross. See, this is the picture of cross. On Friday in Golgotha, Jesus Christ crucified on the cross. So today all the Christians will observe this Friday as Good Friday. This is about early life of Jesus Christ. Hope you all understood, students. In next class I will teach you what are the teachings of Jesus.